of yours. Love yours. No such thing. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing. Heart beating fast, letting you know that he alive.
Well, again, welcome for another series of Dinner and Dialogue. Again, this is the dialogue segment of my series that I've started, talking to some of the more influential people here in Atlanta. And we have with us Devan Dunson, who is an aspiring actor, model, philanthropist, all of those wonderful things. Just wanted to kind of give the people a little bit about who you are and tell them about some of the things that you were involved with.
Okay. A little bit about me. My name is Devan DeMarcus Dunson. So you might see those names, Devan DeMarcus or Devan DeMarcus Dunson. From Dillon, South Carolina originally. Been in Atlanta for about 16 years. Studied up in Virginia at Hampton University. Was fortunate enough to go to New York to work with a couple of people for a minute and really, cut my teeth in the industry as far as my training goes. But a little bit about me beyond that, I really am just an individual that strives to do something that's forever living. My personal mantra is I am forever living. And that simply means, doing something within this lifetime that transcends your lifetime. I like to think that we're all here for a reason. We all have gifts, we all have talents. The only thing that separates us is if you commit to those things. So when I'm creating art in its various capacities, whether it be through modeling, through taking philanthropic works, whether it be acting or music, I like to create work that people can make their own. But if I were to leave here, today, if I were to die, would that work? Would it live on? That's really what I strive to do, just to create that timeless work. When I think about timeless artists, I'm seeing a Marvin Gaye, I'm seeing a Michael Jackson, I'm seeing a Billie Holiday, I'm seeing a Mahalia Jackson, I'm seeing, all of these different icons. And I think the only thing that separated them was at a very young age, they decided to commit to the God-given vision that was within them. And I think we're all given sight, but few of us trust our vision. And that's the thing that I really, really, want to hone in on and really moving forward with my own personal vision, which is, the concept of forever living, doing something within my lifetime that transcends lifetimes.
So. There's something else that you're involved with that kind of ties into that with Black Man Smile. Can you tell a little bit about that? I've been honored enough to be featured in that segment of it, but tell us a little bit about what Black Man Smile is and how you got engaged with that.
Black Man Smile, that's a project that was created by a gentleman by the name of Carlton Mackey. He and I decided to create a platform that celebrated the way we see ourselves as men of color. On the heels of the Mike Brown situation and the Trayvon Martin situation, you saw a lot of negative imagery of black males, African American males. And when we Googled black men smile, very few, if any, images of a black man smiling came back. And that alarmed us because we knew our truth to be different. We knew that narrative to be different. I know several black men who smile every day, who share their thoughts with each other and with their families and with society every day, and they have smiles on their faces. And we're not these hypersexual, over-masculine, desensitized individuals that society attempts to portray us as. So we wanted to create the counter-narrative and be proactive in depicting us in a truer light, our full light. Because we're a dynamic being. We shape the society. So that's why I got behind the project. I came on as a co-director a little over a week, actually, after the project launched. And it's pretty funny how that happened. I took some photos. This is back in 2014. I took some photos for an agency I was attempting to get signed to at the time. And this particular photo, I'm just cheesing. It was at the end of the shoot. And I'm cheesing. And this I posted that photo. I used it just to promote or whatever. And Carlton, who's a professor at Emory University and a phenomenal gentleman, he grabbed that photo off the internet and he used it as the face of Black Men Smile. And he tagged me in it. And then after like a week or two, we noticed that Black Men Smile took off. People were liking this concept. So he called me into a meeting at Emory University and we sat down and we said, hey, you know, we really want to build this thing. We really want to create this concept, this platform, and really empower people. So that's how it started, man. And it was really just one of those things where one brother was inspired by another brother. He saw the light in me, I saw the light in him, and we decided to give that over to the world. And from that, it's grown into an international platform. We're currently on a college tour, the Beautiful in Every Shade and Black Men Smile Empowerment Tour, where we look to hit 50 schools, capture images of these young men at these schools, as well as, you know, Beautiful in Every Shade. It's all inclusive. It's all spectrums, all colors of the human existence. But we really want to get into these schools and get into these communities and help people to see themselves in a better light. What we stand for is self-affirmation first.
Right.
Like, I don't need anyone's validation or approval to let me know who I am, right?
Right.
I learned myself through studying what's been put out. You know, no one's hiding my truth. I just have to seek it. You know, mm-hmm. I did a shoot yesterday with James C. Lewis where he depicted me as an African king. And that was very powerful to me to be considered in that light by, you know, another male of his stature. And it's really phenomenal what we're creating. And I want to thank everyone who supported it so far. And if you haven't seen it, blackmensmile.com, at blackmensmile on Instagram and Facebook as well, Black Men Smile. So when you Google Black Men Smile now, you're going to see those images, the images that you all were, you know, proactive in helping us capture. We want to thank you. I appreciate you. I love you. You have worth. You have value. Go out and really just share that light. Show the world who you really are.
Man, that's awesome, man. That's real phenomenal. I mean, you just gave us an infomercial just then on Black Men Smile. But speaking of which, I think that's awesome because you're doing a lot of great work, and has an immense impact on the society as a whole. Speaking of smiling, I know that you are grinning beyond belief right now with your recent movie. I don't know if it's necessarily a debut, but you definitely had
I'm
some...
I'm coming. I was seeing it a couple times.
Yeah, yeah. And that was a recent movie. Is it a Top Nine?
Triple Nine.
Yeah. Woody Harrelson was in, and a couple
Woody
other
Harrelson,
folks.
So, Anthony Mackie, Kate Winslet, Norman Reedus. Who else? Casey Affleck. A lot of people, man. It was really a great experience. The directors were phenomenal. The producers were phenomenal. The whole cast and crew, phenomenal. It was one of the best experiences I had. You know, they really, during that process, it was just like a family. You know, although these people were of high status in our society, they really were just down to earth, regular people, and that's why the movie turned out so well, because the synergy on set was just that. You know, the directors led by example, the actors and actresses were phenomenal. They were leaders, and they helped bring each other together. The cast and crew, they really looked after each other, and it was a good, really great experience. And I was fortunate enough to be a part of it, and it's just the beginning. You're going to see a lot more. Remember this face, remember the smile.
All right. So you were, what role did you play in that
particular movie? I played the gang unit officer.
Okay.
But, you know, there was a core group of us who played as the gang unit, you know, Casey Affleck's character, as well as Anthony Mackie's character. They were part of a gang unit, an elite gang unit in Atlanta. And we uncovered some things or covered up some things. I don't know. We had fun. If you haven't
did some
seen
things.
We shot at a couple people. We got shot at a couple times.
Right.
But, you know, if you haven't checked it out, go watch it. 999. Bang, bang.
Okay, so what's next for Devan Dunson? What is your next project? What you see in the future, if you can...
Oh, man. What's next? Well, we obviously just had 999, going out to LA, at the middle of this month, March 21st to 25th, I'll be doing some shoots out there. We have Paris, May 2nd through the 9th. We have an exhibition or exhibit out there with James C. Lewis. So we'll go out there in support of that. And really what's next, man, is just taking everything to the next level. If I'm doing acting, next level project, you know, big budget, whatever. I just want to, greatness. That's what's next. You can expect the EP, the music EP called Forever My Truth, that comes out April. There's going to be five visuals to that, five visuals, five songs. Yeah, I just got contacted last night for a pretty cool gig, so that'll be good. This is a Bollywood artist that can't drop any names, but she's pretty phenomenal, and I'm going to be working with her next week. So a lot is lining up, man. There's a lot coming down the pipeline. I don't know what the universe has in store for me, but I'm feeling really good about it. I know that, like I said, the music is coming out. You can expect more films. You can expect more philanthropic work. With Black Men Smile in particular, before President Barack Obama leaves the White House, we plan on going with a group of gentlemen to the White House and getting that experience and being photographed with the president, because you know this is a precedent that was set. He's coming to the end of his 8th term, and I would like to say he did a pretty damn good job. So thank you, Mr. President, on behalf of Black Men Smile, on behalf of Dinner and Dialogue, on behalf of myself. I would like to thank you for the job that you've done, and you are forever, we're forever indebted to you. So that's something that I'm really happy about. And then we're going to be doing monthly community service projects. So we look to get in the communities and do street beautification processes. We look to not only feed the homeless and clothe the homeless, but help them to become contributing citizens again. So we're going to be doing those types of projects. And I plan on going to Africa this year and seeing some things out there, doing some work out there. As well as just traveling a lot, man. Haiti, wherever, Paris, Netherlands, Switzerland, freaking South America and Brazil. I really just want to learn more about my people and all of their different representations, and not only just study these places, but go to these places, be hands-on in these places, and throughout it all, just create work that's forever living, you know, create work that people can, like I said, embody and take on as their own. You know, I don't do this necessarily just for myself, but if I can inspire, you know, 1 million people in this lifetime, 1 million, and have those individuals go out and actualize whatever it is that they have in them, because we all have that thing. You know, there's no person that I think that's more talented than the next. We're all given, you know, God-given gifts, and it's just a matter of exercising them on a daily basis and committing to them, exercising, committing to them, and then you get your results. And a wise man once told me that the success comes after the growth. So for me, I plan on growing more. I plan on, you know, watering myself more and making sure I surround myself with positive people and really just helping as many people along the way as possible. That's really what you can expect from me. And you can expect me to smile more. I promise you, you'll see this smile on a lot of places.
Oh, that's awesome. I really appreciate your time and appreciate your talents and your gifts that you're giving to the world, actually, through your artistry and your determination. So we appreciate you. We're here on Dinner and Dialogue on behalf of us, and we look forward to seeing you in a lot more places and doing a lot of great things.